Hello, my fellow aquarium keepers. My name is Dejan and I'm with eSHa Aquarium Products. In this video, we'll talk about wounds, burns, and various types of damage, which will be a new chapter in our series, Recognizing Fish Diseases. On top of that, we're also going to talk about different types of diseases caused by parasites, and other problems us hobbyists might encounter, such as injuries with completely different reasons and severity. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel. Let's start with mechanical trauma. In most cases, fish get injured because they fight among each other or with other fish species. This can result in different types of injuries of various body parts, such as ripped fins, broken jaws, and beaten up lips, and even eye injuries so severe the fish can go blind or in the worst case lose their eye completely. Fish can be easily startled and as a result make very fast and unexpected maneuvers, which can cause them to damage themselves and decorations and even jump out of the aquarium by accident. There are aquariums in which fish are kept together that are not compatible or become incompatible with age. This can result in an unpleasant situation in which fish damage other fish by eating their mucus and skin. Especially catfish and algae eaters can feed off the skin of slow-moving fish, such as discus fish, angelfish, and even fancy goldfish. Burns in fish can be caused by unprotected heaters. Catfish, different kinds of spiny eels, coolie loaches, reedfish, or ropefish if you will, and other species prefer to hide in nooks of the aquarium and in between the heater and the wall of the aquarium. Thermal burns can be so severe that fish can actually die, so it's important to move the heater behind the background cover of the aquarium or inside the filter if possible, or make sure you have a protective cover in place so there's no direct contact between the fish and the heater. Some parasites, such as fish lice, ankle worms, and leeches, can cause nasty wounds or ulcers in the place where they attach to the fish. There's also skin damage where we simply do not know where it comes from. These can be the formation of ulcers because of bacteria that cause infections. We will talk more about the causes in the next video. In places where there's already damage to the body of the fish, dead tissue can develop, and this in turn makes the fish more susceptible to secondary bacterial and fungal infections. For all the different kinds of injuries we talked about in this video, we recommend using eSHa 2000. Which is a broad range treatment for bacterial infections, fungal infections, and wounds. It's easy to use and simple to apply. Just make sure you measure the right amount of drops needed, for which you can use our online dosing calculator and put the eSHa 2000 drops directly into the aquarium near the output stream of your filter for an even distribution. So let me show you the amazing results of this product. After 7 days of treatment, the wound is almost completely healed. Here's another before example of an injured angelfish. And here are the after results. Here are some more before and after examples. Okay everybody, that concludes our video for today. I hope you enjoyed it as much as I did. I'm Dejan with eSHa Aquarium Products wishing you happy fish keeping. For more videos like these, please subscribe to our channel. Tot ziens!